Welcome to Loop. Here in our shop in Portland, Oregon, we spend our days playing with B&R controllers, giant ABB robots, and even the occasional robot dog. We'd like to be together, but right now our shop looks like this. This doesn't change our goal of revolutionizing technology, but it does change the way that we do it. With loopers and customers scattered all over the country, we need a new way of doing this, and we use a cloud to stay connected to our control systems. In this video, I'm going to show you how to connect your B&R controller to the AWS IoT Core. This is the first step to connecting your system to access serverless computing, database services, and machine learning. Let's start by going into AWS and adding our thing. Sign into the AWS console and navigate to IoT Core, Manage, and Things. Click to register a thing, and we're just going to create a simple thing. I'm going to call this Loop IoT Thing. Then I'll click Next and go to the certificate generator. Download the certificate and the private key, as well as the root CA certificate from the download link below. I'm going to save this in my system as root.ca.pem. Once I click Save, I can go back to AWS and finish setup. Now I need to activate the thing and attach a policy. The policy I'm using is basically an admin policy. For a production system, you'll want to think about what services this thing has access to. Now this is complete and we click register thing and our thing is now created. You can click here, navigate to interact and grab the endpoint of our IoT thing. Now we set up the B&R system. For this demo, I'll actually be using a panel PC 3100 controller from B&R. With a PowerLink bus coupler and some digital I/O. Now, before I program this in Automation Studio, I need to get the libraries from B&R's GitHub page. Follow the link in the description to download the zip file containing the libraries and some example projects. So unzip this downloaded folder, and inside you'll find both the libraries and example projects that demonstrate connections to different cloud platforms. We'll navigate through and just make sure that we see the libraries here, which of course we do. We'll back out of this and open up Automation Studio. I'm going to begin with a project that already has the hardware added to it. So we'll just need to add the libraries and the other resources. So first we'll go to the logical view, and in the toolbox we'll go to Add Existing Library. I'm going to navigate to the unzipped folder with the library repositories inside. We're going to go to IoT MQTT, and we're just going to drill down and find the version that we want. The last unique step here is to add our certificates and private keys. And we're going to do this under Configuration View. We're going to go to Access and Security, Certificate Store, Own Certificates, and we're going to add our certificate that we downloaded from the AWS certificate generator here. Next, we'll go below that and private keys, and we're going to do the same with the private key. We'll add the private key that we downloaded from AWS. And lastly, we need to add the root CA certificates. We're going to go to third-party certificates, software certificates, and we'll add the root CA.pem. That's it. That's all the special configuration for IoT here. Now let's take a look at a pre-built demo project. Under main, I have the function block calls and some quick setup. The parameters action is passing the thing name as well as the endpoint and the path to the certificates. The publish action is passing the publish topic, building the JSON string, and then calling the function block for publish. Subscribe is passing a different string that we're subscribing to, calling the function block, and then triggering a buffer action. I'm using the loop developed Jasmine parse function in C as well to parse the JSON object that's coming in so I can extract the values directly out of it. Now it's time to transfer this project to the hardware and see it working in real time. We'll get this transferred and we'll go then to the AWS console because now everything we're going to do is going to be done through the AWS IoT thing. Now we're using the IoT thing shadow. The shadow is a document that allows things to sync online. It's like a digital twin. We'll create the shadow by sending the MQTT message here, which is also going to queue the first digital output on. So our program is not only writing the output, but it's also monitoring the input and writing that to the shadow as well. So we'll go to the shadow. We'll refresh this, then click Classic Shadow to see the shadow document. The shadow is used as a hub to synchronize different applications and services in AWS. What we're doing here is writing input and output values. In this particular JSON structure, the desired is coming from the cloud, reported is coming from the PLC, and as I toggle my digital input 1, you can see the reported input value is changing. With only a few short steps, we got our B&R controllers connected to AWS. In future videos, we'll expand on this, but for now, thanks so much for watching.